that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. To God be the glory for all the good things he's done in our lives. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Love you.
But we used, first of all, we did Isaiah 60, verse 1 through 5. And then we finished, Elder just read the 2 Corinthians 4, 4, in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. And when we're using the analogy we did last week, when we talk about Chinatown, when the fact is that you don't have to, they don't have to tell you that you're in Chinatown. You just walk into that, and then you know you're into Chinatown. We talk about the fact is that Chinatown is in the city, but it's just not the city. It's something else, right? There's a whole new culture, a whole new outlook that's in that environment. And we're saying is that as you were talking about the fact of dying to self, is the fact is that we die to self so that people can see the kingdom on us, in us. They can see the glorious gospel of Christ on us. They, you see what I'm saying, brother? And you ain't got to tell them. You don't need a t-shirt. you just need to be.
Right.
You know, I mean, you want somebody, when you're preaching the gospel, you're going to do your street ministry, it's something about that's offered within the kingdom on you that a person just starts seeing manifested. They should see less of you and more of the kingdom.
That's right.
And then if we just learn to just live the kingdom, we walk by faith, not by sight. So when people sitting there talking, don't you see what's going on? I see what's going on, brother. But you don't see that. I see something else.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, one thing I see is that the victory has already been won. Huh? Mm-hmm. All we're doing is just walking in our victory. Some of the things that Brother Asim was trying to say is the fact is it has already been done.
Amen.
As far as what God has for you. And therefore, we are now given those things that are behind. You know, in fact, you think about it, should have put in that scripture. Philippians said, "Father, brother, I have not yet apprehended." Hey, that's obvious. I have not yet apprehended. But just one thing I do. Hey, I will leave 2020 behind. I'm trying to press. I'm trying to press for the mark, for the high calling of Christ Jesus, huh?
Amen.
Oh God, I'm pressing. That's when people see you pressing in the kingdom is what God has wanted us to do. We're supposed to preach the good news. And if some of that preaching is not just by our words, but by our actions. Mm-hmm. And that's all he's trying to encourage us to do. Walk in that glory. Walk in that victory. Because that's what it's all about. But one important is Bishop, the title is talking about you shall receive power and transformation. That's what we're talking about, dying to self and being transformed into the image of his dear son. We, one important of letting people see is there's a transformation happening in me. Just like you going to Chinatown, that person was in San Francisco, and then all of a sudden they walked into Chinatown there because a transformation occurred when the people who came from China or came from descendants of China had introduced and transformed that block, that area within a city into a new environment. Huh? Mm-hmm. So the same thing goes with you and me and anybody in the kingdom, is that we are being transformed into the image of his dear son. We want to get to the point that we move from where people see you to start seeing Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
That's where I'm coming from, is about image. That image.
Well, you know, and what you mentioned, and you know, that's a big part of the the problem that I will say, you know, loosely, I say this, the church has right now is that, you know, we look like the world.
Come on.
And so when, you know, things that we should say, things that, you know, what we should do, and I'm not talking about aggression. I'm just talking about, right, having the peace, you know, that the Lord Jesus brought, you know, when he was here and how he conducted himself and many people as far as the how we collectively,
yes.
You know, look too much like the world. And that's a big problem. That's why they call us hypocrites.
Come
you know,
on
a
now.
Lot of time.
Come on.
Yeah,
come on.
Yeah, you know. And then the other thing I want to mention as you were talking is that, and as I was looking, you know, further in the scripture there in 2 Corinthians is that, you know, again, when we are serving God, you know, the thing is when, just like you serve kings, it's for their glory, right? For
Yes, sir.
But you know, the thing that he does is he allows us to enjoy that. He allows us to benefit from that.
Yes, sir.
Not to oppress us, because, you know, we use the word freedom from sin.
Yes, sir.
You know, and that's just a glorious thing about being a child of God is that even though we are created for his pleasure, in his divinity, in his spirit, he just allows us to inherit, you know, yes, that which his son has inherited, you know,
yes,
amen?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen. Yep. And that's part of the good news of the gospel, isn't it?
Yeah.
Inheritance, right?
Yes.
One of the things that Jim used to love to talk about was that forget not all his benefits.
Mm-hmm.
And those benefits should be manifested on you as you walk. Huh? Mm-hmm. Allowing mm-hmm. it to manifest on you as you walk. Allow you to have that victory. And so one of the things is, so I'm really trying to lay that foundation of us conforming and transforming to the image. And bitch, Elder Johnson, one of the things is to start off, this builds a foundation to line up with where we're coming from.